I'm talking to Alexander from the European Committee, and Alexander, you're trying to implement the alternative, what is it called?
Fuels Infrastructure Directive.
Okay. What is that?
So that's the directive is aimed at standardizing all types of alternative fuels infrastructure. So it's for electromobility, electric chargers, but also for hydrogen, natural gas currently, and
natural gas and hydrogen is in the interest. But you've worked a lot on the infrastructure for charging.
Of course, we see that there's a lot of market uptake there, and especially for personal vehicles.
Yeah.
And so, of course, this is now we are following it very closely, what is happening, and we see that there are standardization needs, so we are working a lot on that.
You say that you have promoted, the committee has promoted all kinds of standards, important standards, like OCPI or other things. What have you done?
So, well, there are research projects. It's not necessarily managed by DG MOVE. I'm from DG MOVE, from the European Commission.
Yeah.
But there was a research project, EV Roaming for EU, where NKL, which is a Dutch organization, where they developed, they harmonized OCPI, or they further developed OCPI, which indeed, as you already mentioned, was initially developed in the Netherlands. And they further developed it to make it more suitable for also cross-border roaming use, basically.
And then you help develop a standard like that, and then you try to make it a European standard. You try to promote it everywhere.
So what we currently, the directive focuses on it was adopted in 2014. So it focused mainly on standardization of the hardware, so the infrastructure itself,
so CSS,
the plug types, etc. Indeed. So we have imposed, for example, that CSS should be as a minimum available on all rechargers. Leaving, of course, the option, for example, if CPOs they want to, they can also add Shademo, for example. Yeah. So we want to say at least this one should be there, but you can also propose other solutions to users. So we want to keep it open. We want to keep the market open.
You also have standard that you say every 300 kilometers on the highway there needs to be a fast charger or something like that.
So the directive impose this, mm-hmm. but there are some recommendations. I believe that for the recharges it's one per 60 kilometers on the highway, I think even. But it's not a recommendation in the directive, but it's a recommendation that was later developed by the Joint Research Center of the European Commission. In the directive, we have an obligation on member states to develop national policy frameworks. In those national policy frameworks, they need to set targets for the deployment of infrastructure. And those targets, they are then measured against measures like the one developed by the JRC, the one every 60 kilometers.
So they first have to make their own standards, and then they give you the rope to hang themselves because you're going to evaluate how they're doing. How are we doing in Europe with electric charging?
Let's say
both public and private and fast.
So currently, in general, the member states, they're on track to reach their 2020 targets, but we can see from the assessment that it was clear that post 2020, and we expect a rapid uptake of vehicles, and well, the uptake, we expect that it will happen of the vehicles, but we are not sure that the infrastructure will, you know, will keep up. We need to, I think the public sector needs to step in now and really make sure that these charging points do not become, a barrier for further.
Pain point.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I don't think it's currently a problem, but we need to speed up. We need to make sure that we follow the uptake of the vehicles.
Which countries are doing well in terms of uptake of vehicles?
I want to promote, because I'm responsible for this, for the European Alternative Fuels Observatory. I don't know if you know this.
Okay.
It's a website where it's eafo.eu. where you can basically track all statistics on alternative fuels infrastructure, also on recharging points, so you can closely follow.
Normally, those are fantastic statistics, which are really handy. Yeah.
Yeah, they are very useful for us also to see what's happening. And of course, we see that certain markets are, of course, developing more quickly than others.
Yeah. So Norway, Holland, and the rest of Europe.
Yes, of course, indeed. Yeah.
Do you see acceleration going with cars? Because the amount of companies, OEMs, which had electric cars, is really not going up very quickly.
Yeah, but the expectations are, there was a report of Transport and Environment recently where they said that from 2022 onwards there would be, I don't know how many new models, but I think up to 50 new models coming in the market. So, and then of course, we expect that once the models come, this will go hand in hand also with the uptake by consumers, because once you have more offer, I mean, this is one of the pain points currently. You don't have a lot of choice. Huh? You have only a few vehicles.
Yeah. You have Tesla, and then there's all time nothing, and then, you know, a couple of Koreans are there. It's really not going very quickly.
Yeah, but we understand that now the OEMs, they also pushed by European standards on CO2 emissions.
That's what they said. I said, what really drives forward the electric market? And all the BMWs, Daimler, Volkswagen, they said, European standards of CO2. That is the one driver for electric cars.
Yes, indeed. I think it's one of the major accomplishments of the European Commission of the last years, this legislation. And I think the bar is very high, so we expect that this will push alternative fuels, and probably in the first, most rapidly, we expect electromobility.
Okay. We have a new European committee. Not yet. But almost have a new European, but at the elections, you have the evaluation of the first directive for the next 5 years. Do you think the next 5 years will be accelerating a great deal? That we prepare everything for the big jump ahead?
This is the expectation, yeah, indeed. I think once the models come, then we can expect also that the consumers, there will be more choice for those kind of vehicles.
Yeah. And the European Committee is still very, very motivated to promote this kind of transportation?
So since we are setting CO2 emission targets, which are relatively stringent. Yeah. Of course, we are promoting also the means to reach them. Huh?
Okay. One more fantastic thing which the European community is doing. They did fantastic things with mobile, and are now doing great things with EV. So we should be happy about that 1% we pay for the European community. So thank you, Alexander.
Thank you very much.